Over the last century, advances in technology have aided the warrior on the battlefield. From improvements of the basic rifle to the creation of nuclear warheads, America has always been on the forefront of technology. But the battlefield is close to leveling out. Advanced modern weaponry has become increasingly easier to obtain. The armies of tomorrow, poor or rich, will be able to purchase weaponry that mirrors our own. As we look to the future, we understand that it's not technology which will be our advantage, but the individuals we place within our ranks. The Marine Corps Warfighting Lab, also known as MCWL, wants to utilize NCOs throughout the Corps and get their ideas on how tomorrow's warrior should exploit these new technologies. We believe that the Marine Corps' ability to adapt these future technologies and utilize them to their fullest extent will be the game changer in future conflicts. The MCWL is offering an opportunity for NCOs to temporarily leave their unit to effect change and aid in the development of new concepts. Upon returning to their units, they will be better equipped to provide innovative solutions to everyday problems. Here are just a few examples of how today's warriors are preparing the Marine Corps for tomorrow's battle. Good afternoon, my name is Luke Cardelli. I'm a sergeant in the United States Marine Corps. I'm actually an 0311 serving with Victor 35. Now, how I got to work at the MCWL is actually kind of by accident. Last summer during the MiG-16, my platoon was tasked out with creating a realistic Op 4. In that process, I came up with the idea the enemy uses social media, videos, and things like that to disseminate their message. So what I did was I created a realistic enemy IO campaign that challenged the Marines in the training area. So when they came in, we created these videos and we published them as if they were one on like the BBC or social media or something of that nature. And in the process, we were challenging how quickly the Marines could watch these videos, disseminate information, and update their decision-making abilities for the Marines at the tactical level. Since then, I've come to work with the MCWL, and I've taken this idea and I've really expanded it. And hopefully in the future, every Op 4 will be outfitted with this form of social media capabilities to really test the Marine Corps' ability to combat enemy adversary information operations.
I'm Sergeant Reeder. 0351 Infantry Assaultman by trade, prior with 1st Battalion 7th Marines and then 1st Battalion 5th Marines. The reason I'm over here at the lab is one day some of our senior leadership decided to tell us that grunts were all dumb. And I said, well, not this guy. And I ended up getting my computer science degree, which gave me a better understanding of networking, development of programs, some of the software and hardware. And I decided to hone those skills up a little bit, and I said, you know what, I can really help out the Marine Corps in a bunch of different ways. So I applied over here to the lab. And once I got accepted and got orders, I translated those skills into helping assist in the evaluation of some of these assets that we use, such as the VROD VMAX, the DEV2 variant number 2, and then also helping develop a Op 4.
Hi, I'm Sergeant John Gillis. I'm a machine gunner from 2-2, working here at the lab as a science and technology advisor in the science and technology division. I started working in S&T about a year ago. I saw a small UAS fly for the first time and realized that the enemy was going to be using that against us and that we needed to be able to train against it. So we didn't at the time have any systems, and so I tried to find a way for us to get those faster. And so I started working on a proposal to 3D print them inside the Marine Corps. And so I worked on that project for the last year or so. I've also picked up a couple of other S&T projects. On a day-to-day basis here, I work sort of in two roles. The first one is I serve as a tactical advisor and sort of a operating force advisor on S&T projects. And then I also work as a basically connecting file and translator for engineers and then the operating force Marines. So I try and make sure that the engineers understand what the Marines are asking for and make sure that the Marines understand the assets that they're being given.
We know there's a lot of untapped talent within our ranks, and if you would like to come work here at the Marine Corps Warfighting Lab, you can find out more information about applying at our website. We look forward to having you here.